We are going to discuss about scheduling process queue today. It is the queue with the help of which the whole scheduling process is done with the help of LTS, STS and MTS scheduler. So a job queue is there where the newly created process comes by under stack over there, and from the job queue, one by one, the LTS picks up the process to get executed or put it into the ready queue. Now, when it comes to the ready queue, that is the ready state, the scheduler, with the help of STS, that is the short-term scheduler, it puts the thing to the CPU, and once it is completed, it moves to the terminate state. That is, it's over with that process. But sometimes from the ready state, it might move to the suspended state, which is taken care of by the MTS, that is the midterm scheduler. And while a schedule process is there in the CPU working or getting executed, there might be some event or IO interrupt, according to which from the CPU, this process comes and moves to the block or the event queue. And once the IO or the event is completed, then it again moves back to the ready queue. Now, if there is a high priority process comes, if a high priority process comes in the ready queue, then what the CPU does, the CPU with the help of the timer and the priority line, it sends back to the process which is getting executed of less priority, send back through this line to the ready queue, and the high priority process is getting scheduled in the CPU. And the parent wait is nothing but it helps to wait, that is at the suspended state. For other cases, the parent wait is used. A new process is generally created by fork, and according to this scheduling process queue, the whole part gets executed within the OS. So this is the overall of the scheduling process queue, and this is it for today. Thank you for watching our video. Please to like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.